floatin'. Charlie Wilson in the house. We floatin'. JT, we floatin'. Will.i.am, we floatin'.
Talk to him.
I said, hey girl, I just can't seem to take my eyes off of you.
Sugene with RhythmAddictTV, and we are here today with Justin Cortez.
Hello, how are you guys doing today?
So what inspired your choreography for today?
Really, it's just a piece about, it's just a happy piece. I heard the song like a long time ago, I think. The very first time that I went to ECDC back in like 2007, I guess it was like right before I joined Culture Shock DC. And I've always been meaning to do the song, and I heard it again just a few months ago, and I was like, you know, I think this is gonna be the one. So just made a piece to it and everything.
What song is it?
It's Floatin' by Charlie Wilson featuring Justin Timberlake and will.i.am. I'm doing the Justin Timberlake verse. I love Justin Timberlake's music. He's just a great artist, so I always do stuff to his music.
Yes, for sure. So you're on Tito Boy Scouts, Culture Shock, and you're part of the dance department here at UMBC. Mm-hmm. What are the similarities and differences between...
Gorilla!
Wait, I have to... Alright.
Do you have to?
I have to do something. So, because you're part of Tito Boy Scouts, Culture Shock, and the dance department here at UMBC, what are the similarities and differences between each of the groups?
Well, Culture Shock DC is a professional, nonprofit organization, dance company, and I get most of my training from being with that company. I have for the past 7 years. It's very different from Tito Boy Scouts in the sense that Tito Boy Scouts is the crew that I started with, is my family. Like, it's so much more than just dance with that crew. I grew up with these people. They're my brothers and my sisters. And with the dance department, you know, it's different for me there because I get to try ballet and modern and everything, different types of movement. But what's similar about them all is that movement. So you know, you can utilize any style of movement and put it to any kind of music, and it's just, you can make beautiful things with the different styles.
If you had to choose one specific genre of dance, like you said, like modern or contemporary or hip hop or jazz or lyrical tap, whatever, which would you choose? If you had to only stick to one, which isn't a fair question, but he's very well-rounded, so I'd like to know this question.
I would always have to stick with like hip-hop dance urban styles. Mm-hmm. It's just, I get the most gratification from doing that in particular. I love doing modern, and all of that stuff still like influences me, but I would have to stay with hip-hop in general.
Is there a specific realm in hip-hop, like whacking or housing or locking, that you would choose, or just...?
I like locking. I do. I love to do it. I want to get a little bit better at it. It's one of the urban styles that I get the most joy from, just because it's a very happy dance. It's very different because I would much prefer to freestyle to locking, and then pick up, you know, dance, you know, choreography, hip hop, and everything, and like stuff like that.
Yeah, for sure. So you've been dancing for so long, you know, like, you know a lot about it. Would you, what advice would you give the new dancers, like the newbies?
Take class in everything and everything that you can take class in. I've seen a lot of people stick to things that they're comfortable with, and that makes you good at what you're comfortable at. You learn more from things that make you uncomfortable. So the best thing is to put yourself in situations where you're constantly learning. If you're feeling comfortable in a class, that's the moment where you really aren't learning that much anymore, and you need to find something else to help your movement out.
Right. Yes, I completely agree with your answers.
Thank you.
Yes, they were very deep and in depth. Well, thank you for this interview, Justin.
Thank you, Sugene.
No problem. Well, if you are addicted to the rhythmics, make sure you like, tweet, subscribe, favorite, follow. That's it.
Hashtag.
Anything. Just keep watching, and we'll see you next Monday. I'm sorry.